in conjunction with its 50th anniversary, the main event for the NWA World Tag Team title, the Rock and Roll Express against the champions, the Russian team led by Ivan Koloff.
Tony, it's for the World's Tag Team Championship. The Rock and Roll Express go after the Russians, and that's going to be something.
It's going to be incredible, David, and we're here today with it all right for you, David, and I think we have Johnny Weaver in the dressing room.
That's right. Let's go to Johnny Weaver in the dressing room with the Rock and Roll Express.
We're in the dressing room here with the exciting Rock and Roll Express, Robert Gibson, Ricky Morton, these gentlemen, in just a few minutes going to go out there in that ring for the World Tag Team title. Gentlemen, I know the fans of Worldwide Wrestling would like to know your thoughts right now.
Well, you know, here's one of the biggest matches of our careers that's coming up. But the reason that we're here is to wrestle for those NWA World Tag Team titles. That's something that we work very hard for, and that's the reason that we're here. We know these guys are big and we're tough, and we won't take nothing from them.
Well, good luck from all the fans and myself. They'll be out, and we'll go right back to ringside now.
All right, to help us with the commentary, the United States Heavyweight Champion, Magnum T.A. Magnum, it's good to have you with us. We'll be back with Magnum TA to talk about the World's Tag Team Championship. All right, again, we'd like to welcome the United States Heavyweight Champion Magnum TA to this, the main event of all times. It's for the World's Tag Team title, the Russians against the Rock and Roll Express, Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson. You've seen them, you've seen how they wrestle. Tell us about them.
Well, yes, I have. You know, the Rock and Roll Express have got to be one of the most exciting teams to come on the NWA scene ever. They work together like one man in the ring. They both seem to know each other's thoughts, yet they've never been up against such a formidable team as the Russians. The Russians have turned back the challenge of such tough teams as American Dream, Dusty Rhodes, and the Raging Bull. They've gone up against the Road Warriors, one of the most powerful teams in the sport today, and yet they still are the World Tag Team Champions. So when this confrontation takes place here, I think Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson definitely have their work cut out for them, but it's a competition that I'm looking forward to see.
I think it's going to be the speed of the Rock and Roll Express against the strength of the Russians. And that's something.
I think so, Magnum, because the Russian team really outsizes the Rock and Roll Express by a great deal.
Well, you're looking at a tremendous weight disadvantage the Rock and Roll has given up to the Russians, but still with their quickness, their speed, their agility, and their combined efforts as a tag team, because this is tag team competition. You're not talking about brute force against brute force. It's going to be a competition that each and every one of us is going to be privileged to see here on this television program.
All right, the importance of this match, we have the United States Heavyweight Champion, Magnum T.A., World Heavyweight Champion, Ric Flair, he is here, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Jim Crockett is here, too. So let's go to Jim Crockett, and let's talk to him, if we can, right now.
Fans, I'm here with three distinguished gentlemen, the NWA World Champion, Nature Boy Ric Flair, our World Television Champion, Dusty Rhodes, the American Dream, and Mr. Jim Crockett, President of Jim Crockett Promotions. Congratulations on your 50th anniversary, and congratulations on bringing this tremendous event to television.
We promised our fans some things special this year. Tonight is just an example, and there's some more to come in the future.
Dusty, what about this match?
I think it's a tremendous match. I've been in, you know, former World's Tag Team Champions, and I'm telling you, the Rock and Roll Express, if they're going to do it, they're going to have to reach way down to do it, because they're with two or three of the most powerful men in professional wrestling. I'm looking forward to it, and it's going to be a tremendous battle.
All right, and World Champion Ric Flair. Ric, what about it?
Crockett promised the world he'd bring him the best of professional wrestling. He's the only man in promotion today who could put something as prestigious as a World Tag Team title match right here on national television. I'm proud to be part of it, and I hope to be in a match someday just like this.
All right, fans, right now, let's go back to ringside and David Crockett.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, you heard from the World Heavyweight Champion Ric Flair, Jim Crockett, Magnum. This is going to, again, some match is for the World's Tag Team title.
You know, the Rock and Roll, like Dusty Rhodes says, are going to have to reach deep inside you. This is going to be their toughest test of their lives.
All right, we hear the music, the Russian music. Hey, you see they're getting ready. All right, let's go to a commercial break, and we'll be back with a match for the World's Tag Team title right after this.
Do it. this match for the NWA World's Tag Team Championship. Our opponents, first the challengers. At a combined weight of 447 pounds, Robert Gibson and Rick Morton, the Rock and Roll Express. Their opponents, the World Tag Team Champions from Russia, a combined weight of 500 pounds, the Russian Bear, Ivan Koloff, and Pressure Khrushchev, the World Tag Team Champions. This match for the Tag Team Championship, referee Tommy Young.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, you heard Bob Cottle. This is it. This is for the World's Tag Team Championship. Ivan Koloff and Crusher Khrushchev defend against the Rock and Roll Express. We'll be back with the main event right after this. All right, ladies and gentlemen, it started. Magnum Tony, this is it. There you see the Russians embracing each other. And across the ring, this is the tag team of today, the Rock and Roll Express. Now, fans are ready too, Magnum.
This could prove to be one of the most exciting tag team competitions I've ever witnessed. You're the Rock and Roll Express. The Russians have totally different styles of wrestling. The Russians always rely on their power, their superior power that they feel they have over all American wrestlers. But the Rock and Roll has such superior speed to anyone that I've ever seen. If they can utilize that speed in tag team wrestling together, I think they might have a chance against these men.
All right, it's really going to be who can dictate the pace of the match, who can control. And that is the whole thing. Watch him. All right. Now, Crusher Khrushchev, he has the height.
That's what I'm talking about, that speed there, David. I'm talking about being able to counter that power, counter that big shove that Crusher Khrushchev was trying to execute there, sidestepping him and using his own power and strength against him. That's what Ricky Morton was doing right there.
All right, Morton, he's very cautious. He knows. All right, he goes in, ties up. They take. Watch out, they're back and forth. All right, they're in the corner now. Look at Morton, he's got the knee. A kick, he knows to get out of there.
You know, David and Magnum both, I can't help but look though at the Russian team, how big they are, how much experience they have. And this match is gonna be a grueling match, and as the match gets longer, it's gonna be the advantage of the Russian team because the wear and tear is gonna maybe cut that speed down of the Rock and Roll Express.
Yeah, I gotta tell right now, the fans, this is a first. We have dedicated to this whole program, the whole hour to this, for the World's Tag Team Championship. You know, we have some other matches in case one team wins, but the whole hour is right now. And this is what you've got. It's for the World's Tag Team title, the Rock and Roll Express. There you see Ricky Morton, this young man, back and forth. Now, Magnum, the longer it takes, what happens? The Rock and Roll Express, they get tired. The might, the strength of the Russians, what happens?
I think what we have right here is a case where Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson both have to constantly try to outsmart.
There he is. Look at him.
That's that superior power we were talking about. That's the smart move on Ricky Morton's part because he knows a big man fought on this early in the match that could end it right there.
But he's holding his back. What effect did Crusher Khrushchev, did that slam have on him? He wisely tagged out.
We're talking about Ricky Morton was probably giving away 70, 80 pounds to Crusher Khrushchev in body weight. So the punishment that he takes here is going to take its toll on the Rock and Roll Express much more so than the World of Russians here in the early going of this match.
Listen to the fans. Rock and roll, rock and roll. That's what they want. All right, Robert Gibson's in there. All right, now, quickly gets away from Ivan. There you see Robert Gibson. He's fresh. Tony, he's ready. All right, now the referee's checking.
You know, Ivan Koloff will do that. He will try to get every advantage that he can. Look at him. He's such a veteran. He'll try to get every advantage, but you know he's got to be concerned about this speed.
He's the coach. He's the professor. He's the leader of the team. Switch now. Ivan's trying to, he's got that arm. Turning at it. Quickly, kicks off. Gibson, that's lost.
You know, you watch these youngsters, the Rock and Roll Express on our left, and just imagine what this means to them here today. What's going through their mind, how their adrenaline has to be pumping. You know, they are the underdogs. These are the World Tag Team Champions we're talking about, and they, like you said, Magnum, they have taken on all comers, including the Road Warriors. They still hold on to these titles.
The thing is, the good move. He's got it! He's got it down! He's in! Ivan's down! Makes a tag to Ricky Morton. He got it. Twist that arm. Headbutt in the arm. Has that arm bar. Has it in tight. Ivan's trying to figure out, what can he do? Right in. That jump. Koloff and Crusher Khrushchev. There's that third man. I'm talking about Nikita Koloff. He didn't come out of the dressing room, but he's still around, Magnum. He's still here.
That's why, you know, Nikita Koloff may be one of the most dangerous of all the Russians put together. And when you have that element of surprise, having him in the back, that is something that the Rock and Roll's got to keep in mind when they're out there going after those titles right now.
But still, Magnum, they can't let that affect what they're thinking about. They got to be concentrating at all times in the match, and they really got to put him in the back of their mind.
They have come this far to a match, the first time ever, for the World's Tag Team title right here on television. The whole program's dedicated to this. Look at Ivan right now. He's got Ricky's coming up. These guys have a lot to lose and a lot to gain.
You know, you got to give Ricky Morton some credit that time because he was coming up on a very strong individual, and it took a kick by Koloff to bring him back down.
You know, this Ricky Morton's got a lot more fight in him than a lot of people give him credit for. They look at him, they say he's giving away sides, but a lot of time, it's what you got in your heart. And that's what he had right there. He pulled it out with a good wrestling maneuver, and wrestling's what the name of the game, and the Russians are going to find that out right here.
Thanks to Tag, comes up, drops a knee right across the arm. Arthur going after that arm. That's a good move because that's one of the strongest parts of their body, for the Russian.
Now, see, that's that teamwork I'm talking about. The Russians are trying to change the pace of this right now. They're still doing it.
I tell you what, this Rock and Roll Express is well prepared for this match.
Oh, they're keeping him in the corner, working in and out, making the tags. This is what counts. Has that arm bar. Ivan is still in there, trying to make it over to his corner. Can he do it? Pulls the hair of Morton. I think he pulls on, takes him over.
Tommy Young didn't see that.
And Morton drops. All right, see, he's dropping the knees. Both knees right on the arm. Yanks at it. Pulls at it. Pulls at that arm.
You know, a key to defeating this Russian team, Magnum, and you know that yourself, they're such big men, you got to keep them down on the mat. And that's exactly what they're doing.
That's exactly what they've got to do, and they've got to keep wearing down that one body part. When you got a man that obviously has a superior strength there, you've got to take something away from him. If he gets that one arm worn down enough, that'll be to the Rock and Roll's advantage.
Here it comes up. He's got the arm again. He needs to take him down like we were talking about. Ivan and this team's, he hasn't, look out. He's got him in the corner. Ivan starts to pound away.
That's the wrong place to be right there.
Crusher comes in. He's got it. Hard rights. Takes him. Whips him across into the turnbuckle. Catching him with that elbow right in the chest. Morton goes down.
Ricky Morton does not need to be taking this much punishment this early in the going. He needs to get over there to his fresh partner and make the tag because the big rush can do a lot of damage very quickly.
That's
here.
Right. He slammed him once. He's got him over his head. He's pressing him. Hard. Down on the mat. Right on that back again.
That could be it. Unbelievable that he sustained that punishment and was able to kick out on the three.
You know, we talk about speed and we've talked about speed of the Rock and Roll Express. It gets down to stamina right now.
That's right. How long can they take it? The power of the Russians.
This is where the Russians are at their best. When they get their opponents wounded, when they get them hurt, they zero right in for the kill. All the right. Rock and Roll could be in a lot
Magnum,
of trouble.
You have to agree right now. These fans here, they will determine, too, if this young team of the Rock and Roll Express can hold on. Because when they're behind you, it just, that adrenaline, it just comes out of nowhere.
without a doubt, many, many, many times the fans have been the difference, the thing that swayed the edge in my favor, and I know that the Rock and Roll Express got that same blood running through their veins, and I'm sure these fans are spurring them on right now. Ricky Morton's in a lot of pain here, but I don't see that it looks like he's going to give up.
Listen to him. He's squeezing. Tighter and tighter. Crusher has him. Gibson's out there. He's ready. He's rested. He wants to get in. Pounds in the back. A fist in the back. He's got him up. Maybe.
You got to give the Russians credit at that time. It was a great move by Khrushchev getting to his corner.
He goes down for the pin. He says, count, count, count. Oh! Count of two, he kicked out. The man needs to make the tag. He rolls him over. Kneebreaker. Goes down for the pin again. Count one, two, three. Ivan has him again. All right, we got to go for a break. We'll be back right after this. Ricky Morton is still in there. Crusher Khrushchev comes in and starts to pound away. This young man, he has been taking an awful lot of punishment.
And the reason he's still in there, I mean, it's been real good tag team combination by the Russian team. They have blocked the man from going to his corner. They have done a great job in this match. They are well prepared, but of course, they are the champions.
Yes, they've been very well prepared, but you've got to note, every time the Russians got a chance to take a shortcut, they were right there. Whenever the referee was looking the other way, they were the first ones to try to do anything to take advantage of this Rock and Roll
Express. But now it is, Ricky Morton's been in there, can he make the tag? He cannot take much more. He's fighting. He's fighting. The fans are the only people that are holding him, keeping him from getting pinned. He's got to make that tag. Gibson's on it. He's ready. Come on, make it. We're just 10 feet away. He's trying to fight back. Ivan, he knocked him. Make it. He made it.
Down for the leg, stretching it, drops it. Elbow across the leg, and another elbow. Take the Russians off their feet. We were talking about it. He makes the tag to Morton. Morton, double. Catches Crusher. Goes right after Ivan.
That's
again.
Right. Has Russians are on all their own medicine right here. They're turning it around on him now. If they want to see a tough fight, these men still have a lot of fight in.
Oh, they yank him. Yank at the muscle. Give the Rock and Roll Express a lot of credit. When the tag was made, they could have let anger go to their head, but no, they didn't. They kept their composure. They went right to the leg.
Control.
Right with their game plan.
That's always the key to success, control. You've got to rely on your wrestling skills, your knowledge. If you go off half-cocked, you're always liable to make a serious error. But these men are professionals, and they're out there. Yeah, Crusher Khrushchev wasn't going to be a sucker two times. Oh, yeah, but maybe he is.
Ricky Morton has the leg of Ivan. He makes the tag to Gibson. Gibson comes over. A knee right into the thigh.
Oh, yeah, they've got him. He's got it. There you see. All right, Magnum, he's got that leg. He's stretching it. This is what he wants. He's got to keep him down. Now you see Crusher. He knows they're in trouble.
Yeah, he knows,
what they're doing.
They're making a weak link here. They're wearing something down on Ivan Koloff.
Over. He's got it. He's got it. One, two.
Almost. Ivan's trying to make it over to Crusher. Good leg trip by Ricky Morton. He ties him up. He ties him up in that leg.
Another characteristic of a great tag team, and that's to block the man from making the tag and keep that man in the ring, and they're doing a good job.
Match. What a match. Hey, you see the fans, they're trying to decide who's got it, who can win it, because the way it is right now.
Well, this battle has definitely gone back and forth. I thought they had Ricky Morton in so much trouble that he was never going to be able to make that tag. Yet he did make that tag, and now they've turned this battle around. They've got Ivan Koloff in a lot of trouble here.
Teamwork. That's what it is. Ivan kicking off. Make it. Can he make it? Can he? He's trying. He's trying. All right, Crusher's in there. He goes after Gibson. Pounds away. Forget him. Takes him now. Puts him across. Switch! Crusher comes in. Oh, no! Rammed right in to the corner post. They see Gibson right at our table. Crusher now. Has that leg pulling at it. Pulling. The referee's on. They see Crusher's got it.
You, back where you belong. Now.
AC Crusher. All right, they're in their corner. Gibson's in there. Ivan stretching the cross. Snaps that neck back.
To the Russians saw themselves getting in a predicament there. They were the first one to rely on getting that referee to turn his back. That's how they always turn the tables. That's all the Russians know how to do. And now they've got Robert Gibson in the same predicament they had Ricky Morton in a little while ago.
All right, driving that arm up to the shoulder. Ivan now. He's squeezing it tighter, tighter. All right, we'll be back with this. We're going to have the tape machines rolling, but we'll be back with more. The match for the world's tag team title. Ivan's got him. He's got him in that bear hug. He still has that arm. Tony, he's squeezing it tighter and tighter. Can he hold on?
You know, right here, David, we talked about speed, and I want to remind us, the big men, that Russian team, they're big men. And by, you know, I can't get over the stamina of the Rock and Roll Express.
Well, you got power against speed and agility here, and these men are in excellent physical condition, yet they've taken a tremendous amount of physical abuse at this time. And Robert Gibson definitely needs to make his way over that corner and try to make that tag now before the Russian bear rips that arm right off the shoulder.
Look at Gibson. Look at, can it last? Can the strength of the Russians outlast the speed of the Rock and Roll Express? The young team of the Rock and Roll Express, this is today's team. Can they hold on? Can they do it?
Well, they've definitely shown a lot of heart and guts at this point because they've sustained so much punishment. There have been a lot of times out there when it's been real easy to quit, but they're still fighting their hearts out. They're still going for all the gold right here.
No matter what happens to them, you have to give them credit for fighting all the way to get to this match for the World's Tag Team title. And again, we still have to remember that Nikita Koloff is around in this building. You've got that third man. Gibson's trying to make the tag. The wrong corner.
He's right over near our broadcast location. And you're right, David. He went to the wrong corner that time.
He drives in. Gibson moves out of the way. Crusher hurt his shoulder. Referee Tommy Young starts the count.
That's the agility, but now Robert Gibson needs desperately to get over that corner. Needs to make the tag right here while he's got him down, while he's got him hurt, but he wasn't.
The professor, the coach, Ivan, he's in now. He's rested. As rested as any team could be. Right. Ivan goes out of the way, gets a move. Ivan goes right after him again, gets him. Right hand. But can it handle Ivan? Ivan makes the tag to Crusher. Yeah, all right, they have that arm. All right, Ricky comes in. He's trying to keep running. Crusher, look at him. There you see Ivan. He yanked at the arm.
Once again, taking advantage and stretching those rules. Magnum, you talked about that. They've done it once again.
They do it on every possible occasion. They try to draw your partner in the ring for that particular reason. They double up on the opponent. They almost try to infuriate you with all these psychological games, and then they always try to turn it around on you just like they did in that particular instance.
That's why they are the world tag team. Goes down to the pin. That's why they're the world tag team champions, like it or not. They're number one right now. Ivan's going after the eyes. What a match. What a match. Look out. Here it comes.
Ivan, both knees down on the mat. Referee Tommy Young starts the count. Can Gibson make it, or can Ivan make the tag to Crusher? Gibson's trying to reach over the board. Pressure comes in. Here it goes. A fist in the back. Oh, he's got him. He's got that arm again.
He sustained so much punishment. He's got to be so near exhaustion right here. The temperature in here is unbelievable. The battle they've been in has been unbelievable. And I know right now he's thinking of anything in his mind he can do to make it over that corner, because that's his only way out right now.
The arrogance of Crusher Khrushchev. So Gibson so close to the corner, and Crusher knows it, and he wants Morton to suffer right now, because Morton's trying to reach out, trying to make that tag. He's only two, maybe 3 feet away. Now with the arm extended, maybe a foot. Is he trying to look at Ivan? Ivan comes in. Oh, cheap shot. But oh, Crusher.
He took a bad spill off that ring, David.
He did. He caught it.
Now here he comes in.
He comes in.
He's coming back.
He's up now. They see Ivan in the corner. He got Gibson. Now Crusher comes over, starts to pound away. Like you said, Magnum, they take every advantage that they can of the rules.
Well, Ivan Koloff has probably got to be one of the shrewdest men in this sport today. And he's been around a long time. He knows every trick in the book. And he's not going to let anything happen to let that world tag team title slip up from their grasp right here.
Ramming the head. And that turnbuckle on again. Gibson's trying to fight him, trying to fight it, trying to keep him from doing it. Ivan has his hard right to the chest and another right. Watch him, he's gonna try to ram him right into the mat.
Oh no.
The Yankee, he did it. Gibson did it, pull Ivan over. Ivan landed on his back. Gibson's still down on the mat. Ivan comes in, hard right to the midsection. He's fighting. Come on, Crusher. Now Crusher has the tag. He comes in. Can he make it? Can he last? Here he comes. Kick him. He's just hanging on the ropes, though, Tony Magnum. He's just hanging there. You see him.
He is.
Now he needs to suck it up. He needs to get that last bit of energy. He needs to make it over that corner, because he's got to get out of that ring. I don't know how much more he can take.
Oh, me.
Gibson's in a lot of trouble. You're right, Magnum. I don't know how much more he can take. And the Russian team has really put a lot of punishment
double
on
team
him.
Across.
Oh, my.
He's down.
He went right to his knees and dropped face down on the mat.
Looks to me as if the Russians are anticipating the kill right here. They think
he knows. Are you going to stay up for that pin?
Oh, almost. A split second more, Magnum.
Right now, your lungs are burning. Your feet feel like lead. Can you suck it off?
Beautiful counter move, beautiful counter move. But he's got to make it to that corner. He's got to get himself on his feet. He's got to get over there to give Ricky Morton that tag.
Like you said, he's got to suck it in. He's got to suck it up. He's got to make the tag. Can he do it? Can he get over there? Ivan's down.
It was sheer instinct. He couldn't see Koloff. He could just feel him coming towards him.
Make it.
It was instinct.
Come on. Make it. Get over there and make the tag on. Crusher caught him.
Once again, it's the Russian team that makes the tag.
Morton comes in. He goes after Crusher. Referee Tom Young has to put him out. Crusher comes over. Gets in hard. Yeah. He's trying to fight him off. Can he
He's
do
coming
it?
Back from the grave here. I'm saying this man still got fight in him, but he's got to get over there and make that tag.
Two. Almost.
He hasn't got enough in him to hold the big Russian down. He needs to get over there to his fresh partner. He needs to get out of there, because he's just taking too much punishment on his body right now.
What a mess. Whatever happens. Gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen out there, you are seeing the best. Right here. Oh! He caught him with a clothesline. He caught him. Gets it, caught him, Tony. They're both down.
But he does not have enough energy right now, David, to roll over and try to pin him.
Gibson. Oh, no.
You know, I have to say again, Magnum, it gets down to the bigger men maybe having a little bit more stamina than the Rock and Roll Express. They're able to make the tag.
Gibson trying to get up. He's trying to get to the ropes. Ivan comes over, starts to choke. They cut the wind off.
You can't cut out their desire, though. These two young men, the Rock and Roll Express, they are loaded with desire.
Win, lose, or draw, these men have been given 100% out there. This is the most unbelievable competition I've ever seen.
Randy Orton, right now, look, Crusher switched off. As soon as the referee went away, they come across, knee in the back.
That's a famous Ivan Koloff move right there.
He turns him down, goes down for this that pin. Oh, no! Count of two. I thought he had him.
I did too,
thought
David.
He had him. Gibson. All right, now Crusher. Crusher's got that arm. He's not trying to pin him. All right, this could be a mistake. They right now think they've got the advantage.
Yeah, but what this could be doing is giving Robert Gibson just a little bit of room, maybe to catch his breath a little bit, because it's one thing to have the excruciating pain of having your arm almost torn out of the socket. It's another with the realization that you might be pinned. And he's right now, he's got that desire. Those fans are cheering him on. I can see the adrenaline running through this man
gasping.
Right now.
He's gasping for air.
He has got to get it together here now. If he's got anything down inside that he can draw down and pull out of himself, he's got to do it now.
He's come out. He's come out. He's got that. All right, he's behind. He's behind Crusher. Can he get that leg? He needs to get that leg.
This is where the weight and strength advantage is definitely in the Russian's favor. He's got those two big arms wrapped around that one little arm.
What big arms?
He's got all that pressure coming down on him. He's got to get out of this because he can't use his speed, can't utilize his agility. He's got to get up off that mat and try to get something going here.
Good point, Magnum. That's a much bigger man having the man down.
Martin has had time to rest. He's got to pull it out. Gibson's got to make it. He's got to make that tag. Ivan and Crusher know this, and they're going to hold him there. Right now, Ivan's got one of the strongest parts of it. He's got his legs around the neck of Gibson. Slowly but surely, cutting the air supply off. And you can't wrestle if you can't breathe.
Now, this is probably one of the most excruciating holes in wrestling because it does. It cuts off the blood supply going to the brain.
Wait, what was he doing?
Good call by the referee.
What a break.
I think Ivan Koloff was biting him, wasn't he? We were close enough to hear that.
He can't do it. He can't. Ivan is screaming about a slow count. Referee Tommy Jung, his hand was going down, and it almost hit that mat. Ivan starts to choke again, cutting the air supply off. Referee Tommy Jung starts the count. Ivan breaks it, goes for that pin. They see it. Oh, the fans, they are very intense. Watch.
He's still fighting back, though, David. Still fighting back.
What a man.
He just doesn't have enough behind those punches right now to stop the Russians because he's taking too much of that punishment himself. He really needs to get out of this ring as soon as possible.
Magnum, he drove that spine up into the back.
That was quite a kick out.
Last gasp. Breathe. Get the air in. Suck it up. You gotta make it. Crusher's ready. Watch it.
So when you've been through fighting this long, Robert Gibson lost a little bit of his ring savvy right there. He wasn't even sure exactly where he was, where he needed to go to make the tag. He's probably got a few cobwebs in that head right now. He needs to clear them out so he can get himself back where he needs to be.
You feel like you're in there with him. Wait a minute, both of them down. They hit.
Well, both men are down.
The referee, Ivan's first one up. He's looking around. He checks. He sees Gibson. He sees him. Ivan stretches it back, drives it right in the chest, trying to knock the wind out. Here comes Crusher. Again. The stamina. How long can they last? Crusher takes him over, goes down for the pan. Two, three. Oh! The hand was going down.
You're right, David. The hand was going down, but you talked about stamina. Gibson has taken so much punishment.
It is desire now. Magnum, you have to say it's got to be desire.
You've got to put the title in your head and think about it, and think about it at all times, Magnum.
Well, this is something I can relate to. I remember one too long ago in a battle, I was in the same situation with one Warren McDaniels. And when you get this far fatigued, when you're hurting this bad, you've got to block everything out, all the pain, all the exhaustion, all the fatigue, and think about that final goal you're going for.
Referee Tommy O checking. I think whip him across into the ropes. Cuts off. Try to close up. Gets it time with a knee in the next session. There to finish. He made the time.
He's got it.
He got Ivan. Of course, he caught him with the fist. They come across. In a turnbuckle. Caught him in the midsection. Knocks the wind out. Morton makes the tag to Ivan. What are they going to do? Whip him across. Double team. Wait a minute. Morton's got Ivan. Ivan caught him with a knee. Wait a minute. The other team. The other two are out. The referee's out with him, too. Morton goes. Ivan threw him out. Where's Tommy Young? Tommy Young is down. He's down. Ivan's over there. They've got Gibson. They roll him in the ring.
Look at Morton. He's still down. Now they've got, both of them have Gibson. Oh, what are they going to do?
They're trying to get him out.
That is the most exciting victory that I've ever witnessed. I've never seen a victory roll executed in that particular manner. I've never seen the quickness, the agility that the Rock and Roll exhibited right here. They've got to be on top of the world right now because they are the new World Tag Team Champions.
It's a case of two men, and I mean two men, just coming back until finally, they got the titles.
That's right. You know, Tony, man, it's like you said. They had to desire. They had to suck it up to get in there and win because that team of the Russians, they were pounding away and pounding, but they just kept on. They had that desire. They wouldn't give up. And if you don't give up, you're gonna have it.
Nobody can ever say anything about these men's size disadvantage again because these men took more punishment than I've ever seen any two individuals take during one wrestling match. And they fought with every ounce of desire that anybody could have ever thought about having. And all that fight, all that going through all that tough punishment all paid off right here because now they're the new champions.
And I think it's a day that all wrestling fans, all American wrestling fans, rock and roll fans can be very, very proud of. We have new World Tag Team Champions.
That's right. I've got to say it. Russians, we did it to you. United States, number one. That's all that counts. I tell you, guys, you know, it's all right, let's go to a break, and then we're going to try to get the new World Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express.
We'll be right back with more right after these commercial messages about the worldwide wrestling events coming to your area.
When we talk about the National Wrestling Alliance, you know and I know we're talking about the very best in professional wrestling. All of our fans in Macon, in Albany, and Columbus always like to see some of the very best stars, such as Well, the National Heavyweight Champion Black Bart and men that are hot on his trail, Ron Garvin and Terry Taylor. How about the Midnight Express with Jim Cornette? How about the unpredictable Dick Slater, the problems he has had with Kevin Sullivan? And the list goes on and on. The Italian Stallion, Pistol Pez Wilding, Thunderbolt Patterson. All of the top stars you see here each and every week, because we're telling you that the National Wrestling Alliance is the major leagues of professional wrestling. We don't really have to tell you this. You can see for yourself each and every week all the top stars that we bring right to your living room. So keep watching. All of our fans in Macon, Columbus, and Albany, we receive all your letters each and every week, and we try to answer each and every one. So thanks again for watching. As we said, the NWA is the very best. And now at this time, let's go to my friend Jack Crockett for an exciting rundown of some exciting cards of professional wrestling, the NWA, coming your way.
The National Wrestling Alliance comes to the Columbus Municipal Auditorium tonight. That's tonight, wrestling fans. We have such stars as Pistol Pez Watley, Bob Roop, Joe Lightfoot, Thunderbolt Patterson, Mike Davis, Tommy Lane. We have the Italian Stallion versus Kevin Sullivan. For the National Heavyweight title, Black Bart versus Terry Taylor. Dick Slater, Brett Sawyer versus the Midnight Express with Jim Cornette. In a death match, we have Buzz Sawyer versus Arn Anderson. That's to the finish. Let's talk to Black Bart at this time.
Terry Taylor, there's a lot of people out there that's never seen your face, that don't know what you look like, that don't know what you can do. But you're looking at one individual that knows exactly what you're capable of doing. Now then, it comes down to this. You getting in the ring with Black Bart, taking the title, walking out of there, fancy free and dancing and carrying on with all the girls. But I got some news for you. Black Bart's going to be the one walking out of there, and I'm just going to go to the bar and leave all the girls at home.
Mad Dog Buzz Sawyer against Arn Anderson, a Texas death match. There must be a winner.
Jackie Crockett, first of all, if I came out here and said I wasn't a little bit nervous, I'd be lying. Anybody, any individual, anybody calls himself a man, you included, knows that any fist fight, I don't care who's fighting, any barroom brawl lasts maybe 2, 3, 4 minutes tops. You get in there in a no time limit, no disqualification death match with a man like Buzz Sawyer, that means falls don't count. The referee, all he's there is just to hear a man give up. You get in there with a man like Buzz Sawyer, Jackie Crockett, no falls count, no way to give up, nothing until one man can't answer the bell. It's a little bit scary. That means you can bust a man's head open. He can have 85 stitches in his head, still no finish. I'm a little nervous, but Sawyer, I'm going to be dishing out just as much as I'm going to take. You understand what I'm saying? So when you come on down there to Columbus, people might as well be expecting nothing pretty. If you got babies, take them out to the car. If you've got wives that are pregnant, maybe with a weak stomach, get them out to the car. It's going to be a sickening sight, Sawyer. There's going to be blood from one end of that arena to the other. I'm prepared for it mentally. I just hope you are.
All right, let's go to Johnny Weaver with the new World Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express.
New World Tag Team Champions, if I can fight my way through this mass of humanity of wrestlers here, the Boogie Woogie Man, Ron Bass, the new world champions here, Ricky Morton, get out of here, buddy. Robert Gibson, you did it. A lot of great teams have tried. You did it. Give the fans your thoughts right now.
Hard work just paid off, I'm telling you. The NWA World Tag Team Champions, I'm telling you. Boogie Woogie, Robert, boy, I know it was tough, brother. You sucked it up, man. We come down here for it, and we got it. Woo!
I know there was a lot of tense moments in there. A couple times you guys was really in trouble there, both of you, but you kept on going, and you got it. You got the world belts. The world belts for the
rest. Again, baby, rock and roll may be down, baby. We're not out, baby. See right here, we're all the world's tag team champions, and we're happier than hell, baby.
All right, we got a little footage right there. We'd like to have you talk about it right here. They're going to run the film the last minute or so. Tell us what was happening.
You see right here, sunset flip right here. Robert comes in. We'll go down. But the referee goes out, he ain't able to get up. Then we come back up right here, he kicked me in the head, I'm down. And I'm a legal man. Right here he goes, he throws me over the top rope. Right here, man, I hit my back. Woo! Right here, right there, when I twisted my back and my elbow. Now he reaches through and gets Robert. You see Robert right here in trouble with the Russians here. This is what they're known for, the devious tags. They come down right here. All right, but what they do, they make a mistake. They take their eyes off one of us, buddy, because you got to have both your eyes on the Rock and Roll Express when you're right here. See, I'm coming up right here. I'm looking. I see this guy, bro. And he's fixing to give him a big lariat right here. That's what they use to beat all these teams right here. Here he comes right here. There I come right there. The victory roll, baby. One,
oh, two, yes.
In the Rock and Roll.
And I know that count. I know that count was music to your ears.
There's D's and money right here, baby.
That's right. Jim Crockett right over here. Jim, how about these two guys? How about the Rock and Roll Express?
Congratulations. One of the greatest matches I've ever seen. I'm just proud we could let our fans see something like this here on television. Thank you very much. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Superhuman effort, you guys. I know the Russians are tough. You don't know how many great teams have went after these guys for these belts. You come right here, and you pulled it off, Robert.
You ain't kidding, man. This is all what it's all about. We're here. The prestige here, and we got it right here.
Okay, we got to go back to the ringside.
All right.
Boy, what an effort.
All right, you saw him. Magnum, you heard him. The Rock and Roll Express, the new World Tag Team Champions.
You know, that was the greatest, hardest-fought championship match that I've ever seen since I've been watching professional wrestling, been a part of professional wrestling. I myself am a little drained just from sitting here viewing this thing, yet it does my heart good to see that belt around two Americans. You know, those Russians for a long time have been saying that they are the superior athletes on this earth. They're the strongest athletes on this earth. And what better people to take them out than two good old American boys. Gave away a lot of size, a lot of strength, a lot of weight, but had more fight, more heart, more desire than anybody's ever seen, and then brought them out on top. That victory roll was victorious for Ricky Morton. Robert Gissom, the new World Tag Team Champions, and I'm proud to know them, proud to have them in my corner.
Tony, David, you know, they came on this program after the World Tag Team titles, and we knew halfway through the match, hey, they've made a great name for themselves in the NWA, but who would have thought that these youngsters would have taken these World Tag Team titles? They are the World Tag Team Champions, and I mean it. Like I said before, it has to be a day that all American wrestling fans can really celebrate.
That's right, but there's one thing you both have to agree. You cannot discount the Russians, so you got to watch them. But again, congratulations to the new World Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express. Fantastic. USA number one.
Worldwide Wrestling is a presentation of the JCP Sports Network and has been furnished to the station for broadcast at this time in exchange for commercial